Did you ever wish that you had your own personal handyman? Do you ever think to yourself, whom do I call when my faucet leaks or I need my screen fixed? Just Fix It Inc. can be that company for you. Looking for someone who is professional, honest, knowledgeable, and reliable? Someone who is licensed, bonded, and insured. Someone who is responsive to your needs, regardless of whether your job is small or large. Although many things have changed, in technology, in politics, even the weather, some things were better in the days gone by. Many service companies today are not quick to return phone calls or give estimates on a timely basis. Sometimes it takes even up to 3 or 4 phone calls to get replies. Just Fix It Inc. may be the solution to your household and/or company needs. We specialize in fabrication, repairs, remodeling, and fix up both interior and exterior. We have been in business since 2005 and have serviced many, many clients throughout the Chicagoland area. We will be your special someone who exceeds your expectations. Plumbing, carpentry, electrical, flooring, painting, etc. We are your one-stop shop for all your repair and remodeling needs. Our reputation is our most valued asset, and we will do whatever is necessary to maintain our excellent reputation. Give us a call today and let us know how we can assist you. No job too big or small, we do it all.
Say it one more time.
Number 10 right here.
Yeah.
We're sitting right next to his parents and grandparents.
Oh, right on. In 2012, the Washington County Community Foundation began working on its next big initiative, Education Matters. The goal of Education Matters is to increase the educational attainment of adults residing in our county. The initial focus has centered on adults with some college and no degree. With the assistance of scholarships and a peer mentoring program, the foundation began helping adults return to college to complete their degree or obtain a certification in 2013. Realizing that strength lies in numbers, Washington County partnered with Clark, Floyd, Harrison, and Scott counties to create Education Matters Southern Indiana. This initiative continues to build.
Thank you. you. That's exciting news. I hope this project turns out the way you want.
It's time for the Commissioner's Corner, an exclusive weekly conversation about Indiana high school sports with the Commissioner of the IHSAA, Paul Neidig. Now for an up-to-the-minute report about what's happening in the constantly changing world of high school sports, here's Coach Bob Lovell with Commissioner Paul Neidig.
Welcome back, everyone, to our weekly conversation about the IHSAA. Sitting in to this week will be Assistant Commissioner Brian Lewis in for Paul Neidig. And Brian, thanks for taking time to be with us, and I hope your holidays were great.
Coach, I appreciate you having me on, and same to you, and Happy New Year to everybody listening.
Big new year for everyone in the IHSAA, winter sports in full swing. And you know, over the holidays, it was a perfect time to go watch swimming and wrestling and basketball in various parts of the state. It's a fun time of year for everyone, is it not?
Oh, it's a great time of year. You know, you get some people that get away and be able to spend time with family, but then there's enough basketball games, I know for sure, over a two-week period here to keep you busy. And so, you know, it's a great time to get out and support your local school and watch education-based athletics. And I was able to get out and see quite a few basketball games over the break, and it's always good to see student-athletes at their best.
Well, while you were out, you were watching games and being impressed and in the middle of all the action, and one of the administrative responsibilities you have at the IHSAA is you oversee boys basketball, and you also oversee the officiating program. And we're at a crucial time as a state, and you are as an association, because there don't seem to be enough officials on the horizon. There looms a possible shortage of certified and registered officials. Is that correct?
That's absolutely correct. And I think it's, you know, it's not something that's specific to Indiana. It's one of those issues that has been monitored across the country for quite some time. And we've been able to stage it off a little bit longer than some others. But it's one of those things that we keep our eye on. And we really have a focus on recruiting new officials and younger officials to get into the profession. And at the same time, be able to train them properly so that it's something that they can do for longevity. You know, that we lose officials sometimes within the first 2 or 3 years. If we can get them to 3 years, we got a chance to keep them for a really long time. And so I do want to say thank you to all those officials that dedicate their time and efforts and time away from their families to allow our kids the opportunity to compete in education-based athletics.
Brian Lewis with us from the IHSAA. We're talking about officiating. Well, how is the recruitment effort going for you right now?
Recruitment effort's a 365-day job for all of us. And, you know, we have some exciting things going on. We have officials that work recruiting tents at all of our state finals events. Over the last 2.5 years, we've partnered with a company called Ref Reps that has produced a curriculum that is online, that is digital, interactive, where students have the opportunity to go in from the vision of an official and make the call and learn how to be an official and the basic mechanics and signals, et cetera. But students have the ability to do that within their high school school day and receive high school credit as well as earn a provisional license through the IHSAA. So that's an exciting program that we've got right now in over 70 schools across the state of Indiana to hopefully get young kids involved so that when they graduate high school and they go to college, this may be something they choose to do to make a little extra money on the side and get involved at an early age and continue to do for many years. And so that's a really exciting program, and the IHSA Foundation has done a great job of supplement some funds to get that program going in our high school. So we're really excited about that, but we're 4 or 5 years from really seeing that program pay off as these kids move on and graduate high school.
If you're looking to be an official, log on to IHSAA.com, findout.org, and find out the opportunities. Brian Lewis, great to talk to you. That's exciting news. I hope this project turns out the way you want it to. It's important. It's an incredibly important thing. And so enjoy the holidays, what's left of them. Be safe on your travels, and thanks so much for being with us.
Coach, and thank you so much for all you do for education-based athletics and the support for many, many years. We couldn't do it without you.
I appreciate the kind words, Brian. Thank you very much.
Thanks for listening to The Commissioner's Corner with IHSAA Commissioner Paul Neidig and Coach Bob Lovell. and thank you for your continued support of the high schools in your community.
Thank you. Yeah.